Good morning, everyone. Happy Tuesday, and welcome to day 16 of our challenge. Today's workout is going to be focusing on our pushing muscle groups. So make sure you have a couple of floor pillows or cushions, something that you can prop yourself up for when we do our incline bench press today. You'll also need, obviously, something for weights, your water, and a mat. I'll give everybody about a minute and a half to get settled, and that way you can just jump in and join us, and then we'll go ahead and get started. We will be starting with push-ups today. I know push-ups could be like, to a lot of people, and a couple things I wanted to bring to your attention as you guys are setting up, just kind of listen to this in the background. Anybody can do push-ups. There are several modifications, but the biggest thing that I want you guys to think of is both your hand and foot positioning as you get into those. When you have your arms directly out to the side, if you're gonna go to a push-up, think of just looking at me standing up right here. If my arms are directly outside of my shoulders and really wide, if I'm going in and out, what does that do to my shoulders and my neck? It makes it like really crunch up. No wonder they can be uncomfortable. So if you think when you put your arms in a position to just gently slide your shoulder blades down into your back pockets, just thinking I'm gonna bring them down and back. Now as I'm going into it, it's a much more natural position with my actual spinal alignment. So it'll allow you to hold and support that push-up a little bit more. Also, when we go into them, if you are doing them in an unmodified version, you wanna be in a full plank, the wider your stance, the more stable your environment is going to be. So think about the bigger of a surface area that is physically covering the ground as far as your points of contact, the more stable you will have it. So if you want to make it more challenging, keep your legs really close together. If you want more stability, bring those legs a little bit wider. Otherwise, you could just drop onto your knees and do the push-ups as we get into the set. So that is your tip for push-ups for when we get to them, since it will be our first exercise after the warm-up. Outside of that, let's have fun and build and tone some muscle. Here we go. Let's get straight into that warm-up. Inhale up. Exhale, side bend. Inhale it up. Exhale, other side. Inhale it up. Arms out to the side, chin to chest, rolling it down. Squat at the bottom. Come on up. We really want to loosen those spines up this morning. How's everyone doing after yesterday's workout? Hopefully you're not too sore. Remember just staying active, drinking plenty of water. It will definitely help. It doesn't mean you have to do a huge workout again. Obviously, we're doing one anyway. But if you're sore later, just take a gentle walk around the block. If you have a foam roller, roll it out. It's just about stretching out and being active. You don't have to do the exact same workout. Good God, you'd be really sore if you did that. Come on up and over. Part of the reason that we do the workouts in the order that we do them every week is it gives the muscles a break and then time to recover. We're gonna do one more of these up and over, and then we'll hold it at the bottom. Taking a stretch. Up, over. This time, hold it all the way down. Walk it over to one side, take a lunge. We wanna open up that chest and shoulder girdle. So five reaches, three, four, and five. Straighten the leg, walk it through to the other side. Take the lunge here, reaching it up for one, two, three, four, five. Straighten the leg, bring it back to center. Walk your legs toward each other. Walk it out for five inchworms. Coming on up and down. You can have a bent leg on this if you need. Two more. Last one, hold it down here in your plank. You're gonna do step ups. So this is a Spider-Man plank, taking 10 steps. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Bring those feet underneath you, rolling it up one vertebra at a time. We're going to do three great big shoulder circles here. And then circling it to the front. And then let's jog it out for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and jump rope, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and jacks, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. You guys all feel warm, ready to rock and roll here. We are going to do four rounds all the way through. Each exercise will be 30 on, 15 off, except for one, and it'll be a minute straight through since we're doing the combination move on it. So let me get the timer started. Everybody down on your mat. We are starting with the first interval for push-ups. Here we go. 30 seconds is on the clock. On your marks, get set. Push-ups begin now. So take that wider stance. Up and down. 30 seconds here. If you want to modify it, you can drop your knees here. Bringing it down, working your range of motion. The optimum range would be eventually to get your chest all the way to the ground. 3, 2, 1. Good. 15 seconds off. The next thing we're going to do is go into body weight tricep dips. So you could do this on the ground, or if you want to challenge it a little more to take a deeper range of motion, do this off of the back of a chair or off of a counter. So here we go. 30 seconds. Taking your dip down and up. Really keeping that stomach strong and engaged the entire time. Bend those arms back, squeezing through the arms. Three, two, one. 15 seconds off. We're going to come up and grab a hold of your weights. You could do squats, just holding the weights here, just like this, or you can do a squat thrust where you're pressing the hips forward and the weights out. Either way, here we go. 30 seconds on the clock. Ten more seconds here. You guys are doing great. If you're doing the thrust, really take it down. Pop those hips forward. 3, 2, 1, 15 off, grab those pillows. We're gonna set up your incline chest press here. We will do chest to skull crushers. We've been doing these each week. You guys know what to do. Get those weights in hand. And here we go, a minute. Press it up, turn the weights, bring them down toward your forehead. Extend them up, rotate, press it back out. Up, turn, tricep. Rotate down. So if they're horizontal is a classic press when you go up, and then you turn them parallel to do your tricep overhead extension. Horizontal going up and down, parallel for triceps. Already well past halfway. You guys are doing great. About 20 seconds to go on this. Last 10 seconds here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna come up into a seated position. We have three more exercises of this round. Next one that we're gonna do with or without weights is getting those weights up. Bring the shoulder blades down and back so that you're nice and supported. And we're just gonna do 30 seconds here. Of chest flies.
you really want to focus on keeping those elbows lifted. Try not to let them dip down like this. Lifted, supported, chest is up, shoulder blades are down. Squeezing those weights in. 10 more seconds here. Last three, two, one. Give those arms a rest. We're going to go into alternating overhead shoulder press starting in 10 more seconds. So taking those weights up one at a time. 30 seconds will be on the clock this way. Three, two, one. Here we go. Focus on having a nice and controlled, steady movement, working through your own range of motion. Ten more seconds. Three, two, one. Let's set those weights aside. Scooch the pillows out of the way. We're gonna do reverse crunches starting in about 10 more seconds. So we'll come onto the mat. Hands below your lower back for support. Legs out and bring them in. Last 30 seconds of this round. After that, we take a 45 second rest, grab some water, shake all the muscles out, and we'll start back at the top. Really bring those knees in and out. 10 more seconds. Last five, four, three, two, one. Good, 45 seconds off. We're gonna take everything back from the top with push-ups. So grab some water, we'll do it all again. How's everyone doing? So far, so good? More seconds. If you did the modified push-ups last time, you can even kind of squeak your way up. So let's say that you were here in this modified position. Maybe you want to just see what it's like to modify it with one leg out, one leg on your knee, just to kind of bridge that gap. Give it a shot. I mean, you guys have got it. You are strong. You are warriors. You are athletes. Find that inner strength and push yourself. You've got this. Here we go, 30 seconds on the clock. Find your push-up. I'll do the semi-modified here, one leg out, one knee down, just to show everyone what that would look like. Four, three, two, one, good, 15 seconds off. From here, we're gonna do those body weight dips. We can do it off of the edge of a couch. I'll show that modification for this round. So if you're gonna do those, you'll have a little bit bigger range of motion on your dip. Taking it down and up. Down, up. This will isolate your tricep a little bit more than just doing it from the ground. There's a principle called the vector principle, meaning the closer or farther away your feet are, the more or less resistance there is. So here, if I extend my legs out a little bit straighter, 15 off, it will make that tricep dip far more difficult. If I have my legs closer, it's gonna be a little easier. Grab those weights. Squats or squat thrust begins now. Let's take it down. I'll do classic squat with you this round. Really focus on driving your feet into the ground, squeezing everything at the top. It's almost as if you had a newspaper on you, underneath you that you were trying to rip in half. That way when you're coming up, you're not physically moving your feet, but you're pushing that energy out. And what happens is it naturally engages your abductor muscles and gives you a little bit more support and strength in the legs. 15 seconds off. Let's grab those pillows. We are going to set up for our incline press to triceps. Beginning in 3, 2, 1. Let's press it up. 60 seconds on the clock here.
Press it up, rotate, overhead for the tricep. Taking it back down. Up, rotate, tricep. Halfway there. Seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one. 15 seconds off. We're going to come into seated flies next. We'll get those weights up starting in three, two, one, squeeze them in, 30 seconds on the clock. Ten more seconds. Last five, four, three, two, one, 15 seconds off. We're going to go into alternating shoulder presses next. Let's get those weights ready and begin. 30 seconds on the clock. Let's get it ready for reverse crunches starting in 15. Position yourself on the mat. Bring those hands underneath your hips a little bit. Laying flat, extend the legs out and scoop them in. And remember, you can modify this. You could just walk one leg in, the other leg in, lift them up, and then either both down or one at a time. Or you could do the slide in, and then lift, lift, lower. Feel what works for your body. Halfway there on the set. Four, three, two, one. Good, 45 seconds off. Grab some more water. You guys are doing great. We're halfway through, two rounds to go. You've got this. Seconds left on the clock. Now we're going into Memorial Day weekend this week. You guys have done amazing for the past 2.5 weeks. We'll finish it 3 weeks with the 21 days. Take that momentum and fuel healthy habits this weekend. You know, just portion size when cooking out on the barbecue. Grab some fruit instead of pies and cookies. You guys will be great, and you'll just carry on into next month. Here we go, back to push-ups. Let's begin. This is all about the quality of reps that you do, not the amount. So just focus on form. Last five, four, three, two, one. 15 seconds off. We're gonna go into triceps next. So we'll stick with it on the ground. I'll show you how to do it with just one leg this time if you wanna go that variation. So taking the one leg out, pressing it up and down. Kind of an intermediate between just having hands and feet on the ground versus having your hands elevated off of a couch or a table. Makes it a little bit more challenging, but kind of bridges in between the two options.
four, three, two, one. Good. 15 seconds off. We're going to come up to goblet squat or squat thrust next. You could also do the squat thrust with a single weight if you prefer, holding onto the edges just like this. 30 seconds on the clock. Seconds here. Four, three, two, one. Good. Let's grab our pillows for incline press and triceps. Five more seconds. Get into position. Grab those weights. And let's begin. 1 minute on the clock. Pressing it up, rotating them parallel, overhead tricep extension, squeeze it up, rotate, down, lift, turn. Try to keep everything in your body stable and supported. The only thing that should be moving here is your arms and your shoulders. Everything else is actively engaged. Try to fight resisting any kind of rotation or movement. This is all in your arms. 10 more seconds. Three, two, one. Good. Come to a seated position. 15 more seconds and we will start flies. Let's get those weights up. Beginning in three, two, one. Squeeze it in. Same principle as when we do our push-ups here. Remember to slide those shoulder blades, the scapula, down into your back pockets. We'll give you that much more support and be that much more comfortable in this movement. Five more seconds. And 15 off. Shoulder presses will begin next. Take a deep breath. Lift the chest up. Relax those shoulders from that position. Then we'll do our alternating presses. Seconds on the clock. Ten more seconds to go. Last three, two, one. Let's set those weights down. We'll set up for our reverse crunches. Beginning in 15 seconds. Coming onto your mat, placing your hands right behind your hips or your tailbone. Knees in and extend them out. If you want to challenge yourself a little more, try to lift your upper body and your chin off the ground at the same time. Keeping your upper body slightly elevated the entire time, and then really squeeze your stomach. Every time you pull them in, give that stomach a little squeeze. Last four, three, two, one. Fantastic. 45 seconds off. We're going to go and do this one more time. We're going into the final round, so let's make this last set our best set. Grab some water, shake it all out. We're going to do it one more time. 30 seconds. Catch your breath. Here we go. Get some water. You need to just move around for a second. This is the time to stand up, walk it out, shake it out, rotate those wrists. We're going to start with push-ups. Last set begins in about six more seconds. Let's come back onto those mats and let's begin. Here we go, 30 seconds on the clock. Halfway there. Make adjustments to your form when needed. If you feel like yourself is sagging, widen your stance or drop to your knees. 3, 2, 1. Good, 15 seconds off. We're gonna move into dips next. I'm gonna do mine with the opposite leg extended this time, just to even it out. Taking it down and up. Ten more seconds here. Last 3, 2, 1, come on up. Next set is goblet squats or squat thrusts. Grab those weights. Starting in 4, 3, 2, 1. Squat it out, press it forward. More seconds. Three, two, one. Good. 15 seconds off. Let's grab those pillows. Setting up for tricep and incline chest press. Here we go. Come onto the mat. Starting in 3, 2, 1, weights up, 1 minute on the clock. Pressing it up, rotate, tricep skull crusher. Straighten it, bring it back horizontal. Weights down, pressing them up, turning them parallel, taking them over to your forehead. Squeezing it at the top, rotate it back to horizontal, and bringing it back home. You've got this. About 20 seconds to go, almost there. Last 10. 4, 3, 2, 1. Fantastic, 15 seconds off. We're gonna go into the last set of flies. Throw those pillows out of the way now. We are done with them. Okay, flies begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go, 30 seconds. Focus on squeezing them in, fanning those shoulder blades open. Squeeze in through the chest, fan the shoulder blades back, and squeeze. Halfway there. Four, three, two, one. Weights down. Give yourself a couple of shoulder rolls. We're gonna go into alternating shoulder press in about 8 more seconds. Take that deep breath. Relax the shoulders, lift the chest, sit upright, spine is tall. And that is your starting position. Alternate the shoulder press, 30 seconds here. Very easy to slouch over. Feel like you have a string or a puppeteer pulling you from the top, keeping your body lifted. Good posture is so important. It really impacts every aspect of your mood and how you feel. All right, let's set those weights aside. We are going to our last set of reverse crunches. Here we go. Let's get onto the mat. hands underneath your hips to tailbone for support, legs out, and bring them in. Give those little crunches here, 30 seconds. Halfway there. Four, three, two, one. Awesome job, you guys did it. All right, let's cool it down. So we're gonna start from a seated position and work our way up. So I want you to cross one arm in front here, stretching through the back of the shoulder. Do a couple of wrist circles while you're at it. You did a lot on your hands with those push-ups, so let's just loosen that up. And now take the tricep up, holding onto the outside of the tricep, edge of the elbow, giving a gentle pull there, and then take a deep breath, side stretch over into it. Inhale up, let's change arms. Crossing it in front, rotating the wrist. And then let's take that tricep up, give a gentle tug just to engage the muscle, and then side bend over. And come on up, let's do a shoulder roll here. Bring your feet behind you. We're gonna come up to a standing position. Now if you have a wall or something nearby that you can hold on to, we could take a deeper stretch, placing one hand to the side. You could just rotate open. It's going to stretch the whole front of the shoulder into the front of the chest. So basically, if you're standing right to the side, place one hand on for support and then rotate away until you feel that stretch. And then we'll do the same thing on the other side. Stand towards something, I'll just hold on to my TRX here, and then rotating away to feel the chest opener here. And rotate back in. We're gonna take your hands, bring them behind you. If you have a towel or a strap that you need to hold on to, just to hold them here, that's fine if you can't reach your hands. Otherwise, bring your hands behind. Lift the chest, roll the shoulders back, and just gently pull those arms down and back to open across the entire center front of the chest. And then let's release. Do three great big shoulder rolls to the back. And then let's reverse that to the front. You guys did awesome. How did that feel today? Big breath in. So really proud of yourselves. Exhale through center. You're rock stars. I will see everyone tomorrow for our polling workout. Great job just kicking butt today. I'm really proud of everyone. And I can't wait to see everyone tomorrow morning. Have a great day.